Okay, so welcome back to another episode of the Jaguars Rebuild. We are going into week four up against the 1-2 Cincinnati Bengals in Cincinnati. Last time out, we got handedly beat by the Arizona Cardinals, losing 70-21. We are up against the Cincinnati Bengals in Cincinnati. It's not going to be great. Commit one or fewer turnovers isn't going to happen. We all know we don't look after the ball well. We fumble. We throw picks an awful lot. Now we'll move on to the press conference as we've got a QB1 check-in. Your team has struggled out the gate so far, and when that happens, a lot of blame is usually placed on the quarterback. Who needs to step up? Well, everybody, obviously, the team does. The age-old saying is that football is a team game. We win as a team, lose as a team, take the blame as a team. No one player can pull us out of it. And we just got to beat the Bengals because of that. Now, obviously, Trevor Lawrence has to step up, throw in double digit picks isn't going to help us. But at the same time, we need to give him time. He's thrown for 829 yards, 5 touchdowns, and only 14 interceptions. We need to try and limit now till the end of the season to 8. 22 picks is my goal, to get that or less. Obviously, 14 in 3 weeks means I'm probably going to throw 60 picks, but that's the goal. But yes, we do need to start getting better there. There's no way the Bengals' best offensive player is going to be Nick Mullins. It just can't be. I don't even know what Nick Mullins is doing on this screen. It's ridiculous. But with Joe Burrow and Joe Mixon, this is going to be difficult. Especially with Jamar Chase, their offensive weapons are ridiculous. So I don't think it really matters who we defend. We're going to end up losing somebody, no doubt. So we're going to defend the outside run, as is suggested there. And hopefully we can win. They pass over half the time, so maybe he's defending a pass. We'll defend the deep pass. I'm not really sure it matters which one we go for. Like I said, they're going to be difficult to stop anyway. We've got the runs. We don't have the runs. I don't have the runs. Run inside, run outside. I should clear that up. There's nothing wrong there. DJ Reader. Says blitz counter. I think we'll throw it short. Will be the game plan for us going forwards. Throw it short and runs. Running the ball is what's going to be needed. Now, the game plan. I'm not going to get 200 rushing yards. We're not going to get 350 passing yards. We're going to go with the throw for 2 touchdown passes. Again, I'm going to go with the no conversions on 4th. Because I'm not sure they'll get into 4th down situations again. We'll look to rush for 150. We'll look to throw for 275 there. And we'll look to win the turnover battle. Although, again, I don't think that's going to happen either. So we'll get the training sorted. We can hopefully have no injuries. They've all got a plus one in fatigue, which doesn't surprise me as we are on a short week, apart from the kicker and punters. So, yeah, everybody's got a plus one fatigue, but if that's all they've got, then that's fine. So with all of that complete, we are gonna head on into the game. So here comes Joe Burrow and this very explosive offense that Cincinnati have. And there's a tackle on Mixon. So we'll hold him to a 5-yard gain. Send a little bit of a blitz. Oh, and I'm tackling the tight end who doesn't even have the ball. Yeah, tackling the tight end isn't going to cut it. Need to tackle a ball carrier. Look to stop the run again. Ah, just got pushed out of his way. But Josh Allen gets in with the stop for a 2-yard gain. And got another stop. That's it. Wilson and Allen combining to hold him there. And it's now 3rd and 5. Let's send a bit of a blitz. Let's see if we can get home to Joe Burrow. Jamar Chase over the top, and that's, he's just torched Tyson Campbell there, the rookie. And that is the explosive offense. Just one pass straight down the end, straight into the end zone. And that's what they can do to you. And so out comes Trevor Lawrence and the Jaguars offense to try and answer back on the Bengals opening touchdown drive. As Robinson catches the ball there, takes it down for a nice 9-yard gain, giving us a 2nd and 1, which this is what we need. We need some really short 2nd downs if we're gonna do anything on this offense. And that's a nice 1st down there from James Robinson on the 4-yard rush. As Travis Etienne comes in for this one. We'll change the play. And Arnold's got the catch and another 1st down for the Jaguars. As Trevor Lawrence has gone 2 for 2 for 24 yards. And that is impressive considering how we've started. I mean, we have had 1st drive picks. So I'm not going to complain about that. So I'm going to send Etienne on a jet touch pass. So we've got a big 3rd down coming up. And oh, Arnold just couldn't make the catch. 4th and 6 on their 42, and I can't risk it. We're going to have to punt this away and hope for a good. I think that's far too powerful. Yeah, put that. Oh, that was, well, not miles into the end zone, but just a little bit less on that was needed. And so here comes the defense looking to stop. Get a stop on this offense. There's a 4-yard rush. I can't remember who I'm I got beat, and now just let it run past me. Miles Jack calling out the plays. And there's a tackle on Joe Mixon. Stops him for two. These are things we've got to celebrate, the little wins. because if we don't, well, it's not going to go well for us. So we'll celebrate the little wins, which is those sort of stops. Ah, it's T. Higgins gets the first down there. And another tackle on Joe Mixon, this time from Cisco. Takes Shaquille Griffin. And Mixon on the out as I had taken Jamar Chase away. That's a third and one that we now need to try and stop. I think I'll blitz Miles Jack. Shaquille Griffin steps up and makes the tackle. Can't stop the first down. I'm on wing guard, which I didn't mean to be. Being on wing guard helps me step up and stop T. Higgins. Third and goal. And this is a big third down here. Stop them, hold them to three. That's what we need to do here. No, and he's T. Higgins. And that's 14-0 already. This is a big drive here. We need to get points off this one. After going 14-0 down as Marvin Jones gets that catch for 2nd and 3. Look for Arnold on this one. Or Chuck. Etienne can corral that in. Oh, 3rd and 3 already. That's not good. I'm going to go with double slants here. Etienne. I'm going to send on an out route. And he can't catch it. He can't. We're on our own 32. I can't go for this. I mean, they'll probably score anyway. We probably won't get the stop, but I can't risk going for it on our own 32. Oh, I didn't get to stop him in time. And we're giving them even more yardage. What a stupid penalty. They don't need any of this help. Hamilton there and Smoot with the stop for 2nd and 7. Tyler Boyd with the catch, 3rd and 3. We need this big stop. We need this here. And we haven't got it. Tyler Boyd with the catch again, and Joe Burrow's a perfect 7 for 7 for 110 yards and 2 touchdowns already. And we are only in the first quarter. Get some defense going. We need to try and get a stop. Otherwise, this is going to be another Arizona Cardinal game. Guessing about where you're going to go with the football. And we got a sack. We took everything away. Hamilton got in there with the sack. That's a second and 20. Forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards. That's what we needed. Another one of those would be nice. Stop the run. That's now third and 22, sending them backwards again. Now let's get a big sack here. I mean, I'm getting greedy now. Get two good plays and I'm getting greedy. I'll settle for an incompletion. He's literally... Step up, it's Chase, make that tackle. Well done, Miles Jack. And that's a fourth and 10. We're going to make them settle for three. I mean, we're not going to pound the rock with ETN, but... try and get this running. It's only a couple. Selected the wrong play. We'll see how this goes then. Wonder if we can... get Arnold on the hot route. It's fine. It's fine. It's not what I wanted, but it's a check down. It's a third and fourth. It's what was needed. And I'm only really looking for Chenault or ETN. I'll look for anybody else, but they're the main ones. There's the catch. That's the first down. Got the first down. Well done, ETN. Big catch. Took the hit beautifully. Took it like a champ. Let's get this ball moving. Let's get... oh, 9 yards there. Second and one. Holy stuff. Do you know what? I actually... like this as a run. First, second. There we go. First down. Only a couple, only about three. But that's all we needed. Now we'll chuck a bit of passing in. Get out the throw. Oh, get out the throw. But Marvin Jones came back and got the ball. And it... not only came back and got the ball, but turned and got upfield, getting a first down. That was a bit of luck, but I will take it. Need luck in this game. Need luck. In the NFL. And that's what we got there. It's not what we got there, though. As James Robinson gets stopped behind the line. That doesn't stop me from running it when needed. And we've got Chark, DJ, with the first down. Down to the 15-yard line. And the ball is moving nicely at the moment. We're taking time off the clock. As we get some nice blocks, and that's a flag. He's got an 8-yard gain there, and it's going to come back for a block. Yes. Ah, offense. Jacob Hollister. Don't want him picking up too many flags as we are first and 17. As Chenault gets the ball and gets a few out of that. And that gets us back to second and 10. He was never going to catch that. The linebacker was just too... he's just too big. Three. No. No, nearly picked. That should have been a pick. Should have been a pick. But I'll take the fact that it's not. We got a little bit of luck on that drive. And we took three. Taking down T. Higgins there. Well done. 2-1. Again, not sure on everybody's name just yet. And Miles Jack gets in for a big stop there. Stopping that first down. It's now third and one. Miles Jack gets a little bit of swag going. See what we can do. Can we stop them? No. I didn't know, as the linebacker, I didn't know who to cover. I was going to go with Higgins. And then I saw another two receivers coming out, and he ended up wide open. And there's Josh Allen out wide to make the stop, forcing a second and inches. Now Wilson blitz. Joe Mixon wide open there just to get out of bounds to stop the clock. I'm going to tell the defense I'm blitzing. It was right over my head. Tried to get a little bit too clever. Defend the pass. Damn it. Need to try and stop it so that they have to settle for field goal or they run out of time altogether. That would be the... Miles Jack stopping the catch. It's a shame because it stops the clock. Which wasn't really what I wanted. There's a flag, hopefully that's holding. As he gets out of bounds, 4th and 7. Is that a hold? That's a hold. See. Decline, accept it for 2nd and 20. Decline for 3rd and 7. Now I'll push them back. That's going to be the best thing for us, I think. Defend the pass, come on. Ah, run right past him. Get Mixon down, that's it. Let's try and get a playoff. Stop Jamar Chase, that's it. I mean, it's a third down, I believe. Get 4th and 1, so they're going to go for the kick. That is, the last two drives have been somewhat successful. We've held them to field goals on the last two. We're getting there. They have scored, obviously, on every drive, which is disappointing. But we've held them to two field goals on the last two drives. And Agnew's gone! Agnew's gone! He's going! We're going to score a touchdown just before the half! They can't catch him. He's down at the 5. And he's home. And it's a touchdown for Agnew. A kickoff return touchdown. Right at the end of the half. That's unbelievable. He slowed up a bit as I went to do a little bit of taunting, which was silly. But we've cut that lead down with that kick return for a touchdown. We've now cut the lead down to 10 going into the second half, and we get the ball back. We can be down by 3 by the time Cincinnati get the ball back. What a huge play from Agnew. That's going to get him game time. That's going to get him noticed. We get a run with Robinson, but there was no blocking Davis Gaither from the outside there. But we had no loss. It was a second. So we're now on 2nd and 10 as we try a Jets pass. And he gets to the outside. Ah! DJ just couldn't hold the block that little bit longer and went down to a 3rd and 6. So we've got a big 3rd down here. Gets it to Chenault, who can turn upfield. Gets tackled as he tries to juke past the 2 on rushing defenders, but that's a huge gain, and we are 1st and 10, and we're up to just over midfield now as we are on the Bengals 47. Etienne comes in for the rush, cuts it back, dives up the middle there, stretches for the 1st down, but doesn't quite make it. It's 2nd and 1, and this offense is finally clicking. This offense is finally moving after that big loss last week. Some words were had in the dressing room, and it seems to have worked. It seems to have galvanized the team. The defense is playing better. The offense is moving. The offense is clicking. As they start moving the ball downfield methodically. Catch for Etienne as he just plays it safe and drops it in. So that's a nice catch from Etienne as it's 2nd and 7 now. As that's not a good play, and Trevor Lawrence goes down for a sack, drops it to a 3rd and 14. That's a momentum killer, that. It's a bit of a momentum killer, but we can look to get that back to try and make a man miss. As under pressure, inaccurate, Etienne couldn't get there. It's a 4th and 13, and it's a 54-yard field goal, and it's against the wind. I'm not sure if the kicker's got the leg. He has. 54 yards for pardon me, I'm getting too excited. I can't get my words out. It's a 54-yard field goal. Down by a touchdown as Joe Burrow brings the offense out. Up to Jamar Chase, and Shaquille Griffin cannot make the challenge, but he's out of bounds before the 1st down marker. And it's a 2nd and 1. So they go for the run, cuts it back, gets a tackle, but I think he's just about got that for a 1st down. He has. It's 1st and 10. As Miles Jack's going to go on a blitz here for Joe Burrow. And he's... Miles Jack got straight off his lineman there, but Joe Burrow got the ball out quickly to save getting hit. And it's 2nd and 5. But the talk from the team, the harsh words from in the dressing room, that's me. I bought that completely. Well and truly bought the play action, leaving my space wide open. But the harsh words seem to have made an impact. They had an embarrassing 70 to 21 defeat. And again, I've bought the play action. I'm buying these play actions far too easily now. And if I'm Joe Burrow, I'm playing it all day, if that's going to be the case. So I'm going to drop back. I'm going to take over as wing guard. Oh, no, I'll take over as Wilson, since there's no play action to be had. Left your man, Ben. Left your man. Cover the left hand side. Cover the side of the field you're on. Don't go running across with the player. You're not playing man coverage. Come on now. But yeah, this team had an embarrassing defeat. They had some harsh words to be said, and it seems to be doing the trick this week. And it's knocked down at the line by Jenkins. Rose like Jesus from the ashes. Jesus from the ashes? Like Jesus from the dead at Easter. Rose up and just knocked that ball away. And Jamar Chase is all on his own. Who's leaving Jamar Chase? I shouldn't have spoken about God or Jesus. That's what you get for talking about Jesus, is he goes and lets Jamar Chase get wide open. Starts with a run. Ooh. Nearly got there, but he only got a yard gain. Go for a pass. Let's audible ETN. I'm going to have an out to the right. Dan Arnold there with the catch for a big first down, as Trevor Lawrence is now 13 for 20 for 100 some yards. I missed what it was there. But it's a big first down from Dan Arnold. As we're up to our 47 yard line. And Robinson just got stuck there. Gets tackled for a 2 yard gain. No, that's not good. That was not a good throw. The moment I threw it, I knew it was bad. Are they going to send everybody? Will they dare send everybody? No, they won't. But then they don't need to. 94 gets Hubbard, gets in on the sack. And all that momentum that we had after the touchdown at the end of the first half and scoring 3 points going into the second, we've just blown it all by conceding the touchdown and then going three and out. But now it's time for the special team stepped up. We need the defense to step up and get three and out here. As Joe Burrow's back out to try and send a dagger. Mixon just bowls over three there. And Miles Jack's missed him. Can Tyson Campbell catch as he can't? And just like that, Joe Mixon has bundled through three defenders and run 70 yards for a touchdown. And it's not quite 70 yards. That is an exaggeration, I know, but it's probably not actually. It's actually probably not. No, it's an 80-odd yard touchdown. So I didn't even give him the credit he deserved for running an 80-yard touchdown there. And that's now 34-13. Got to start throwing it a bit now. Can't just rely on runs, as we are down quite a lot. DJ with the catch there for second and two. As I just need 2 yards out of Robinson for this run. And he gets them. Nearly got more. But gets tackled. And it's now first and 10. As we're going to look to stretch this one to the outside. Out of Illinois State. Always got it. And all he did, finished turns upfield but gets tackled the moment he does. Gets a yard out of it. As ETN now comes in to try and get some of this 9 yards needed. And there it is, there's the first down. If he could have just broken one tackle there, we could have had a huge play. We look to take advantage. Going to launch it up for Marvin Jones, and he catches. Oh, he's dropped it. Second and 10. As I generally thought he had the step, but no, he's picked him. No, he hasn't. Somehow managed to recover quickly there, the defender. I need a play that's going to get me at least 10 yards without the worry that we're going to get picked. Trying to go deep. That should do it. No! Manhurts got dragged back. And it's a 4th and 2 from their 38. And the play caller says go for it. And do you know what? I think we do. I think we've got to go for it. I'm not sure if I trust the run on it. What have we got? Audible style. Quick slants. Play action read. He's gone caught up. He got caught up. That was pass interference. He literally had him blocked all the way there. And for some reason, I couldn't get off Dan Arnold. Didn't really have anything else. And I was about to get sacked. Did I really have anything? Didn't really have ETN open. Didn't have DJ. Didn't really have anything. Maybe it's Marvin on the comeback, but Pratt just managed to run the route perfectly and it bounces off his head. I don't regret the decision. I don't. I think I should have trusted the run more. But it was the right call. And I think it was the only pass that was on. So I don't regret it. Mixon's through again. This Cincinnati team is starting to have its way. Their offensive line is starting to do whatever it wants. And Joe Mixon's just running anywhere he pleases. As they start the run down, but we got to stop there. 2nd and 8. As Miles Jack just took the blocker out to get in. Oh, the lineman's just popped out of nowhere, gotten off his block. I just needed a step, just a step quicker, and I had that stop for a huge loss. But as it is, it's a 1st and 10. And we've got to stop there, but still a game. There's 2nd and 7, and Joe Mixon's rushed for 165 yards, and I know one of them was an 80 yarder, or just over 80 yards, but it's still 165 that, and whatever else he gets that goes up. Who's on Jamar Chase? It's a fumble! Fumble, but Uzmara was able to recover it. 3rd and 7. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys like that, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them one. It's a then I'd go for it on 3rd and 7. And I don't blame them, because they convert. Oh, it's a pass. Jamar Chase catches it. 330 yards. He's only missed 3 passes, Joe Burrow. So I'm not sure this is realistic, because Joe Burrow hasn't been sacked once. And we know Joe Burrow can't tackle Mixon. We know Joe Burrow isn't protected by this line. But today, they're doing everything they need. I've got the tackle in. We stopped him. I'm surprised we managed to stop the touchdown at that point. Doesn't really make a difference. We're still going to no doubt concede here. Is he? Yeah. Cuts it in. It's an easy touchdown in the end. And that's 41-13. As they start posing with the dab. You deserve to lose just for dabbing. Try and get a quick score. As there's DJ with the catch. And that's 179 yards for Joe, not Joe Burrow. I wish it was Joe Burrow, it's Trevor Lawrence. It's DJ. Oh, he just can't. Just couldn't quite. This is going to be my last deep shot. Knocks it out of his hand as he's got it in the air. And it's a 3rd and 10. I mean, it's 4th down territory, really. And that's intercepted. That was a poor pass. Trying to force it. Yeah, I don't know if we call it a win just because we managed to... We only managed to throw one pick. Might split Cisco. Just 2 minutes remaining. Yeah, there's the 2 minute warning. The commentator says it's one sided. I think one sided's a bit harsh. We were in it for a bit. Well, granted, we weren't in there long, but we were in there for a bit. That's 4th and 1. Joe, you know what? Let's take a timeout. Why not? But yeah, it's a little bit respectable considering some of the defeats, especially that last one. And there was under pressure in that pass. And that's our biggest problem so far, has been inability to give Trevor Lawrence enough time to just throw the ball. Sandwich between two. My guys can never come down with those air catches. And Dan Arnold manages that catch. We're going to go no huddle. Stop the offense from No, it's just bounced. Oh, bounced off his back. But we're going to go for a drive. We're going to try and score. Do our best. No, I've... Might as well just run the same play. What's that? Run another play. As Manhurts gets the catch and straight down. Let's go no huddle. Let's ramp this up. Let's not give them a chance to... Ah, DJ. And luckily that wasn't intercepted. My guys haven't really got any pace. My receivers. So we send him up, send Robinson upfield, and he's out of bounds with the first down. He was wide open, nobody was touching him. I didn't want to just give him a check down. Just a playmaker him up the field. Oh, he's diving. Why is ETN diving? You've caught the ball. You've beaten your man. All you had to do was turn upfield. And he dives. Dives backwards. That's not what I want from my guys. Oh, why am I not looking at the clock? I wasn't even looking at the clock. That's poor clock management. That's awful, lad. That clock management just sums up the season. I've let the clock run out as we're trying to score to make it 41-21, but it's not. The game is over. It's 41-13. 0-4, and we are on to the next one, which is the 2-2 Titans at home. We've got players ready to negotiate. We'll sort that out in the next episode, but yeah, here we are. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this week's one, which is easier to enjoy more than last week's, because not last week's last video, because there was barely anything of it, again, that my apologies for that one. But I felt this one was a better video, better game. Week four, even though we lost, wasn't really any grumbling by me, wasn't really any annoyances. So, and we had a really exciting moment where we were turning touchdowns. So yeah, hopefully you did enjoy this one. I know I did. So please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time when we take on the Titans at home.